श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। क्षीणवृत्ते अभिजातस्य इव मणेः गृहीतृग्रहणग्राह्येषु तस्थ तदंजनता समापत्तिः। फर्स्ट वी हैव लर्न्ड व्हाट इज समापत्ति, वेयर इन द चित्त इज ओनली टोटली तन्मय विथ आइदर द ऑब्जेक्ट और द सेंसेस और द गृहीतृ द एक्सपीरियंसर एंड देयर आफ्टर दिस समापत्ति इज वी आर सीन ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स डिपेंडिंग अपॉन व्हाट इज द ऑब्जेक्ट। इफ इट इज स्थूल देन वितर्कानुगत सूक्ष्म विचारानुगत एंड सो ऑन। देयर आफ्टर वी हैव सीन दैट तत्र शब्दार्थ ज्ञान विकल्पैः संकीर्णा सवितर्का समापत्तिः। When the Shabda, Artha and the Jnana, all these things are together included in the thought, then it is called as Savitarka Samapatti. And when Yada Punaha, Shabda Sankeda Smriti Parishuddhau, when the mind is freed from the impurities of the knowledge and the Shabda, then Artha Matra Nirvasa Nirvitarka. This we have seen in the 43rd one, and thereafter we have seen etaya eva savichara nirvichara cha sukshma vishaya vyakhyata. So savichara nirvichara samapattis are with reference to the sukshma vastu, savitarka nirvitarka were with reference to the sthula vastu, the gross one. And after having come to this, now we are in the 45th sutra where the topic taken is yathokta vikalpa rahityam rahityam api ubhayoho savichara nirvicharayoho etaya eva purvoktaya eva nirvitarkaya yathokta vikalpa shunyaya sutrakarene vyakhyata iti abhiprayah. So by this nirvichar and savichar are explained. Now this last one, that is this nirvichar samapatti, how long it can go? Sthula we have seen, the gross one, it can expand. Now the sukshma, the subtle samapatti, up to what extent it can go? That is the topic. So in the 45th sutra it is said sukshma vishayatvam cha alinga paryavasanam. When we have studied the different tattvas according to the Yoga Siddhanta, 25 tattvas, there we have seen certain terminology. That terminology should be clear for us to understand this sutra. When it is said alinga paryavasanam, alinga means what? So alinga is the mula prakriti. So sukshma vishaya, the subtle object which is taken by the chitta in its samapatti, sukshma vishaya samapatti. So how long it will go, how long it will continue? So we are told these pancha mahabhut are called as vishesha parinam, tanmatras are called as avishesha parinam, indriyas are called as vishesha parinam, Aspita is called as avishesha parinam. महत्तत्व इज कॉल्ड एज लिंग परिणाम एंड प्रकृति मूला प्रकृति इज कॉल्ड एज अलिंग परिणाम. तो दिस अलिंग शब्द इज इंडिक यूज इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सूत्र सूक्ष्म विषयत्व च अलिंग पर्यवसानम. इफ यू कुड फाइंड आउट दिस चार्ट इन योर बुक वेयर दिस होल जगत इज एक्सप्लेन अकॉर्डिंग टू योग शास्त्र प्रकृति एंड पुरुष पुरुषाज आर मेनी प्रकृति इज वन एंड दिस प्रकृति इज कॉल्ड एज अलिंग परिणाम देन दिस प्रकृति बिकम्स महत्तत्व दैट इज कॉल्ड एज लिंग परिणाम एंड दिस महत्तत्व फर्दर गेट्स डिवाइडेड इन टू अस्मिता एंड अस्मिता इज कॉल्ड एज अविशेष परिणाम इज अ कॉमन थिंग आईएनएस इज अ कॉमन एक्सपीरियंस एंड द 11 इंद्रियाज दैट इज द विशेष परिणाम. Similarly, the pancha tanmatras are avishesha parinam. They are common. All the five elements, the shabdas, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha, they are common. But because of this, the pancha mahabhuta, they are the vishesha parinam. Because each tanmatra is having only one gun, shabdas, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. But when you go to the pancha mahabhutas, then they go on adding by the grossification. So this is what is the prakriti and the expansion of prakriti according to our yoga shastra. Now here the topic is, sutra is, sukshma vishayatvam cha alinga paryavasanam. How far this chitta will be focused into the subtlety? What is the limit of subtle objects? Now the limit of subtle objects is explained here very beautifully, very simple also. So, द सूक्ष्म विषयत्व च अलिंग पर्यवसानम द सटल ऑब्जेक्ट्स कैन बी ट्रेस्ड अप टू द मूला प्रकृति. दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द सूत्र. सो हाउ इट इज फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन द भाष्य यू कैन सी पार्थिवस्य अणोः गंध तन्मात्रम सूक्ष्मो विषयः आप्यस्य रसतन्मात्रम् तैजसस्य रूपतन्मात्रम् वायवीयस्य स्पर्शतन्मात्रम् आकाशस्य शब्दतन्मात्रम् इति. सो ग्रास ऑफ द अर्थ द सूक्ष्म विषय फॉर द ग्रास अर्थ इज द तन्मात्रा द गंध. द ग्रास इज द वाटर एंड द सूक्ष्म इज द रसतन्मात्रा. इन दिस मैनर वी हैव सीन ऑल द फाइव तन्मात्रास तेषाम अहंकारः. Now, subtler than the tanmatras is what? Subtler than the tanmatra is the ahankar or the asmitatattva. And thereafter, asya api lingamatram sukshmo vishayaha. And what is subtler than this asmita or the ahankar is the buddhi or the mahatattva. So, asya api lingamatram sukshmo vishayaha. Now, lingamatrasya api alingam sukshmo vishayaha. And subtler than the mahatattva is the alinga or the mula prakriti. And further, nacha alingat param sukshmam asti. Now subtler than the alinga mula prakriti, there is no subtler thing in that. Here a question is raised. Nanu asti purushaha sukshma iti. No, how do you say? There is nothing subtler than the prakriti. Purusha is the subtler. पुरुषान्न परम किंचित सा काष्ठा सा परागति. सो हियर द टीचर सेज नो व्हाट यू आर टेलिंग इज राइट सत्यम यथा लिंगात परमलिंगस्य सौक्ष्म्यम न च एवं पुरुषस्य. सी द अलिंग प्रकृति इज सटलर देन दी बुद्धि आर द महत्तत्व. In the same way, the Purusha is not subtler than the Prakriti. What is the reason? He gives the reason. The reason is, Kintu lingasya anvayi karadam Purusho na bhavati hetustu bhavati iti. Because Mahatattva is the modification of the Prakriti. And when the Mahatattva gets modified, it becomes अस्मिता और द अहंकार. वेन द अहंकार गेट्स मॉडिफाइड इट बिकम्स पंचतन मात्राज. वेन द पंचतन मात्राज गेट मॉडिफाइड दे बिकम द पंच महाभूताज. एंड वेन द अस्मिता तत्व गेट्स मॉडिफाइड इट बिकम द 11 इंद्रियाज. इन दिस मैनर फ्रॉम द अलिंग प्रकृति मूला प्रकृति अप टू द ग्रास दे आर द कार्य कारण भाव दे आर द उपादान कारण मटेरियल कॉज इन दिस मैनर पुरुष डज नॉट बिलोंग टू दिस कैटेगरी दिस इज व्हाट इज सेड हियर किंतु लिंगस्य अन्वयी कारणम पुरुषः न भवति बट द पुरुष इज नॉट द उपादान कारण मटेरियल कॉज ऑफ द लिंग और द प्रकृति एंड देयर फोर देन व्हाट इट इज हेतु तु भवति इति इज द इफिशियंट कॉज एंड दिस इज वेयर वेदांत शास्त्र एंड योग शास्त्र डज नॉट एग्री इन द वेदांत शास्त्र वी टॉक ऑफ दिस निमित्त एंड उपादान कारण द इफिशियंट एंड मटेरियल कॉज टू बी वन And here they end up into the duality. And therefore, Yoga Shastra, it has done such a wonderful way up to this. But after coming over here, they get the wrong channel. Therefore, Purusho na bhavati hetustu bhavati iti. Ataha pradhane saukshmem nirdishem vyakhyatam. And therefore, the pradhana or therefore, अलिंग आर दी मूला प्रकृति इज द अल्टीमेट निरतिशय सौक्ष्म्यम इट इज द सटलर देन द सटलेस्ट एंड इन दिस रीजन दी सूक्ष्म विषयत्व च अलिंग पर्यवसानम सो एज अ रिजल्ट व्हाट विल हैपन दिस चित्त विच वॉज बिकमिंग समापत्ति विथ डोंट फॉरगेट द ओरिजिनल थॉट दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द समापत्ति And from samapatti only we go to the sampradnyat, asampradnyat, samadhi. So the chitta when it is taking the sukshma vastu as the object, then it is called as savichara and nirvichara. Savichara is when the other attributes such as desha, kala, vastu, vyakti, paristhiti, they are associated with the sukshma, then it is called as the savichara. And when we remove all those attributes and only the sukshma vastu matra, then it becomes the nirvichara samapatti. Now this nirvichara samapatti, how long it can be traced, how it can be extended? So we want to know which are the sukshma subtle objects. So the subtle objects are starting from the Tanmatras onward and you go up to Linga Paryavasanam, up to the Mula Prakriti. So this is how ultimately we will come to know that is Chitta merges in this Mula Prakriti. And when the Chitta merges in the Mula Prakriti, Purusha is liberated. So only that Purusha is liberated. And then he goes and helps others. This is how is the understanding according to the Yoga Shastra. Now, after having said this, in the 46th Sutra, Ta eva sabijas samadhihi. Ta, that means the four kind of samapattis that we have seen. Ta chatasraha samapattayaha bahir vastu bija iti samadhihi api sabijaha. Now what is the samapatti we have seen? When the chitta takes the form or the akara of that particular object, it is called as the samapatti. Now, samapattaya bahi vastu bija. So when the mind or the chitta has taken the form of a particular external object, so in the womb of the samapatti, there is the external object. And therefore that is called as sabija. Because the samapatti is sabija, therefore we call samadhi also sabija. Now here there is one very important thing to be noted. Samapattis belong to the chitta. Samadhi belongs to the sadhaka. See? We do the purification of the heart, antakkaran shuddhi. Purusha shuddhi is not required, purusha is always shuddha. So that antakaran shuddhi, what we talk about in Vedanta, is spoken here as the samapatti. So when these four types of samapatti are spoken of, they become the sabija samadhi, Because in the samapatti, in the sattvic vritti, there is the external object, artha matra. There is no shabda, there is no jnana. But the artha, the object alone is. And in this manner, tatra sthule arthe savitarka nirvitarkaha. Sukshme arthe savicharo nirvicharaha. Iti chaturdha prasankhyataha samadhi iti. In this manner, there are four types of samadhis. They are with reference to the sthula artha, the gross object. It is savitarka and nirvitarka. And with reference to sukshma, it is savichara and the nirvichara. In this manner, they are of four types. So, these four types of samadhis are the ultimate, not more than four. Now, here it is explained. Vitarkanugata sampradnyat samadhi is having the support of the sthula vishaya alambanam. And there will be two of them, savitarka and nirvitarka. Thereafter, all the samadhis with reference to the subtle objects, they will be always savichara and nirvichara. So which are the subtle objects? External objects are sthula, gross, and subtle objects are first the vritti, the thought. So vichara anugata sampradnyat samadhi will be savichara nirvichara. Then the ananda anugata sampradnyat samadhi, which is at the level of the sense organs, that will be also savichara nirvichara. And then the third aspita anugata sampradnya samadhi, also at the level of the grahitra, the experiencer, that also becomes savichara nirvichara. In this manner, there are only four types of samadhis with reference to this samapattis. Therefore, in case of the gross object, you get all the four of them. Savikara, nirvikara, savichara, nirvichara. But with reference to the grahana, vishaya samapatti, with reference to the sense organs, it is only the savichara and nirvichara. And so also with reference to the asmita, it is only savichara and nirvichara. Now, when one is thus practicing this samapattis and also the samadhis, what will happen as a result of this practice? In the 47th sutra, the teacher tells us, nirvichara vaisharadde adhyatma prasadaha. So, ashuddhi avarana mala apetasya prakashatmanaha buddhisattvasya rajastamobhyam anabhibhutaha svachaha sthiti pravaho vaisharadyam. Vaisharadyam means what? Immaculate purity. You know the example the other day I gave you about the pure water, and you add dung into that and stir it. So the presence of the dung in the water is the tamoguna, and the because of the stirring, the movement in the water is the rajoguna. So these are the impurities. So when you practice these four types of samadhis or samapattis, we come to a point where when this nirvichara sukshma samapatti is practiced for a long period of time, as a result of which nirvichara vaisharadde, the nirvichara samapatti leads to the ultimate is what? Absolute purity, no trace of rajas and tamas. This is what is called as here avaranam. Avarana mala apetasya. So avarana is because of the tamoguna and mala is because of the rajoguna. So when these two things are removed, then what remains? The sat buddhi tattva. Buddhi tattva is only prakashatmanah because it is now sattva, matra. So when the buddhi tattva is sattva alone, there are no impurities of rajas and tamas. As a result, what will happen? Raja tamo bhyam anabhibhutaha. So in that Shuddha Tattva, that Chitta which does not have the limitations of the Rajas Tamas, is Anavibhutaha, not influenced by them. Therefore, Swachha Sthiti Pravahaha, the mind always remains immaculate, alert, non-sleepy, because there is no Tamoguna. Not agitated, therefore there is no Rajoguna. So it is a mind, it is the chitta wherein the effect of the tamoguna, the nidra, alasya, pramada are not there, and the effect of the rajoguna, agitations and disturbances and desires are not there. That condition is called as the vaisharadya. This is called as vaisharadyam. Vaisharadyam is purification. Now, yada nirvicharasya samadehe vaisharadyam idam jayate tada yoginaha bhavati adhyatma prasadaha. When this kind of chitta is maintained by the yogi for a long period of time through practice abhyasa, then tada yoginaha bhavati adhyatma prasadaha. Then the yogi attained the adhyatma prasad. Go to Bhagavad Gita. Prasade sarvadukhanam hanirasya upajayate prasanna chetaso jhyasu buddhi paryavadishtate. After studying these yoga sutras, this is a homework for you all. When I am not here, find out these various terms which are appearing in Bhagavad Gita, and in the light of these terms, then again read the same verse. See the difference. Because there Bhagavan says, first of all he gives the parampara, wherein he says buddhi is disturbed because of sangha, sanjayate, kama, kama, and all that thing. And then ulti buddhi nashat pranashati. Thereafter he comes to that the one who is controlling his mind becomes totally quiet and prasad. Then prasade sarva dukkhana mahani rasya upajayate. Why? All the miseries are removed because rajas tamas is deleted from the chitta. And when the prasada, yes, this is adhyatma prasada, when this prasada takes place, then that time bhutartha visayaha krama anupa krama ananurodhi sputaha prajnyalokaha. Then prasannata is prajnyaloka. Prajna, the buddhi, intellect, aloka, the light. And what is that one very important word here is krama ananurodhi sputaha. Krama ananurodhi. There is no sequence because of this, because of that. No. Then the buddhi tattva becomes so pure and powerful and clear that it is able to comprehend everything in one go. See? The knowledge becomes exhaustive and total. Like, we have to study, we have to go this samapatti, that samapatti. We are going, according to the sequence. But for this yogi who has attained this nirvichara vaisharadya, for him there is no need to go step by step. And this is what is called as intuitive knowledge. In intuitive knowledge there is no cause and effect. We are directly told, Mahatmas have this faculty, so they casually tell us, don't go, it's not good. So, why they have said you ask them, they also don't know. Okay, go then, and you go and suffer. Therefore, here, adhyatma prasadaha bhavati, and when adhyatma prasada takes place, then bhutartha visayaha, then the meaning of the whole thing is revealed in front of them. This is how, under this condition alone, all the great rishis were revealed the various mantras in the Vedas. Otherwise, what is that which can give a cause? Then why this particular mantra was revealed to Vishwamitra?
ओम तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो न प्रचोदयात. वेयर फ्रॉम दिस मंत्र इज द परफेक्ट थिंग हैज कम. सिमिलरली इन केस ऑफ वाल्मीकि ऋषि, व्हेन ही सीज दैट सम व्याध हैज कम एंड किल्ड वन ऑफ दिस क्रौंच पक्षी क्रौंच बर्ड, एंड व्हेन वन ऑफ देम फेल डाउन द अदर वन वॉज क्राइंग एंड कंपैशन केम इन हिज माइंड एंड इन दैट ही डिलीवर्ड द फर्स्ट अनुष्टुप छंद. सो हाउ दिस हैपन्स, दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ दिस. देयरफॉर निर्विचार वैशारद्य अध्यात्म प्रसाद, एंड द वन हु हैज दिस अध्यात्म प्रसाद भूतार्थ विषय क्रम अनुरोधी स्फुट प्रज्ञालोक, देन ही गेट्स दैट नॉलेज विच इज ऑल कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव एंड इंस्टेंटेनियसली. तथा च उक्तम एंड इट इज सेड ऑल्सो व्हाट इज सेड, प्रज्ञा प्रसाद आरुह्य अशोच्य शोचतो जनान भूमिष्ठानी वशैलस्थः सर्वान् प्राज्ञोनुपश्यति. जस्ट लाइक ए पर्सन हु इज सिटिंग ऑन द माउंटेन टॉप, हाउ ही इज लुकिंग एट द पीपल डाउन. सपोज देर इज नो फ्लड एंड सो मेनी थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग एंड दिस मैन इज ऑन द टॉप ऑफ द माउंटेन, सो फ्रॉम देयर हाउ विल ही सी, untouched by all that is happening over there. In the same manner, this prajna prasada aruyaha, he who has attained this prajna prasada, then first is ashochaha, first thing. Now see, these two words you take, prajna prasada and ashocha. Okay? Go to Bhagavad Gita. अशोच्यान्वशोचस्व प्रज्ञावादांश्च भाषसे. सी देयरफॉर द वर्ड्स यूज इन भगवद गीता दे हैव गॉट वेरी डीप कनेक्शन विद द कंप्लीट योगशास्त्र, एंड विदाउट द नॉलेज ऑफ दिस योगशास्त्र व्हेन वी स्टडी और ट्राई टू रीड और इंटरप्रेट भगवद गीता वी गिव अवर मीनिंग टू दोज वर्ड्स. So there also Arjuna has used the word prajna. Here is the word prajna. Yoga Sutras are earlier than Bhagavad Gita. So prajna prasadam aruhya ashocha shochato janan bhumishthaniva shailastaha sarvan anupashyati prajnaha. So this prajna purush stita prajnasya ka bhasha samadhistasya keshava stita dhi kim prabhasheta किमासीत व्रजेत किम. सो अर्जुन हैज आस्क्ड द क्वेश्चन विथ रेफरेंस टू दिस. इफ एवर इट इज पॉसिबल दैट द चित्त हैज अटेन्ड निर्विचार वैशारद्य एंड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच देर इज नो डाउट देर इज नो कन्फ्यूजन, यदा ते मोह कलिलं बुद्धिर्व्यति तरिष्यति तदा गन्तासि निर्वेदं श्रोतव्यस्य श्रुतस्य च श्रुति भी प्रतिपन्नाति यदा स्थास्यति निश्चला समाधासि समाधा वचला बुद्धि तदा योगम अवाप्स्यसि. फर्स्ट यू हैव टू अटेन समाधि एंड देन द योग विल कम. एंड वी हैव सीन एवरी समाधि इज नॉट योग, ओनली दैट समाधि विच टेक्स प्लेस इन द एकाग्र भूमिका ऑफ द चित्त और द निरुद्ध भूमिका ऑफ द चित्त. That samadhi alone becomes yoga, not every samadhi. Therefore, Bhagavan says that unless you have attained samadhi at the stage of the ekagrata, it will never lead you to the yoga. So, tada yogam avapsasi. Now, this is the reference with which those verses are to be read. So, prajna prasadam aruhya ashochaha shochato janan. Therefore, Bhagavan has told Arjun, you are talking like a very wise man. And wise man is the one who does not cry. And ashochananva shochastvam prajnyavadamscha bhashase. Talking like, they are talking like a wise man. Wise means what? This understanding. So, tathacha uktam,
प्रज्ञा प्रसाद आरुह्य अशोच्य शोचतो जनान भूमिष्ठानिव शैलस्थः सर्वान् प्राज्ञोनु पश्यति. नाउ हियर दिस इज द अल्टीमेट अस्मितानुगत निर्विचारा समापत्ति इज कॉल्ड एज द वैशारद्य. एंड व्हेन दिस थिंग टेक्स प्लेस देन अध्यात्म प्रसाद चित्त नैर्मल्य becomes free from rest, tamas for good. So, Atmani buddhau vartate iti adhyatmam tadrusha prasadaha adhyatma prasadaha. This is a very good definition. What is the meaning of adhyatma prasadaha? Atmano buddhau vartate iti adhyatmam tadrusha adhyatma prasadaha. So that peace which is when the buddhi is by itself, it has not been running up here and there, Shuddha Sattva. So, in this manner, when the Buddhi is merged in the Self, then it is called as the Adhyatma Prasada. Now, as a result of this Adhyatma Prasada, what happens next step? Rutam Bhara Tatra Prajna. Now, tasmin samahita chittasya ya prajna jayate tasya rutambhara iti sajna bhavati. Now, when he who has attained this prasada, adhyatma prasada, adhyatma prasada is mentioned here as samahita chittasya. So, the one who has attained this samahita chitta. See, again go to the sixth chapter. जितात्मनः प्रशान्तस्य परमात्मा समाहितः शीतोष्ण सुख दुःखेषु तथा मानापमानयोः. तो शीतोष्ण सुख दुःखेषु तथा मानापमानयोः, व्हेन दिस डू नॉट डिस्टर्ब यू, यू हैव ऑलरेडी अटेंड दिस दी वैशारद्य. एंड एज ए वैशारद्य अध्यात्म प्रसाद, व्हेन अध्यात्म प्रसाद टेक्स प्लेस, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज समाहित चित्तस्य या प्रज्ञा जायते. That experience when the mind or the chitta is established firmly in this sattva alone. Ya prajna jayate tasya rutambhara iti sajna. It is called as rutambhara. Rutambhara means what? Rutam means the satyam. So satyam vibharti iti rutam. That which is able to hold, discover, recognize the truth behind everything is called a satya, rutambhara. So, is called as the rutambhara prajna. Now, this rutambhara prajna is anvartha chasa, satyam eva vibharti. Anvartha means what? It is standing to its name. Like, you know, somebody is called as, let us say, Saraswati. But there is only doing the job of cooking. Why? I never studied. I don't know anything. Cooking I can do. What is your name? Saraswati. Ram, Ram, Ram. So that name Saraswati does not suit to that. Or somebody's name is Lakshmi. And what is doing? Washing the clothes. So, Lakshmi was in the clothes in your house? Yes, I am Narayana. See. So, here, Rutambhara, this name suits Anvartha. Therefore, Anvartha chasa satyam eva vibharti. It is right according to its name, it supports, it holds, it recognizes, it comprehends the satya, the truth. Nacha tatra विपर्यास ज्ञान गंध अपि अस्ति इति. सी देर आर अदर थिंग्स इन द नॉलेज. व्हाट इज द विपर्यय एंड अज्ञान एटसेट्रा. सो देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ रॉन्ग नॉलेज आर नो नॉलेज आर द अपसाइड डाउन नॉलेज. The things are recognized exactly as they are. And this is Rutambhara Prajna, is the one which is referred in our Kathopanishad.
एष सर्वेषु भूतेषु गूढोत्मान प्रकाशते दृश्यते तु अग्रया बुद्ध्या सूक्ष्मया सूक्ष्मदर्शिभिः सो दिस इज द ऋतंबरा प्रज्ञा विच इज मेंशन्ड इन द कठोपनिषद सो ऋतंबरा प्रज्ञा न च तत्र विपर्यास ज्ञान गंधा अपि अस्ति तथा च उक्तम एंड इज द सेड व्हाट इज सेड आगमेनानुमानेन ध्यानाभ्यासरसेन च त्रिधा प्रकल्पयन् प्रज्ञां लभते योगमुत्तमम् इति सो फॉर दिस योगी हु इज हैविंग दिस अध्यात्म प्रसाद फॉर हिम दिस विशेष प्रज्ञा इज हैपनिंग बिकॉज ऑफ व्हाट आगम अनुमान एंड ध्यानाभ्यास थ्री थिंग सो व्हाट वी विल कॉल दिस आगम अनुमान एंड ध्यानाभ्यास इज द श्रवण मनन एंड निधिध्यास So we have heard in Shravan all these things, right from Yoga Chitta Vritti Nirodha, and we have gone through the whole journey about what is happening to the Chitta at every stage. Now we have come to a point where all the Vrittis regarding even the subtle objects are quietened. And now the Adhyatma Prasad has taken place and now Ritambara Prajna has awakened. So, this has to be again and again practice. Therefore, Agama Anumana Dhyana Abhyas Tridha Prakalpayan Prajnam Lavate Yogamuttamam. And when these three ways the Prajna is sharpened, then one attains the Uttamam Yogam. So, what is the Uttam Yoga? Uttam Yoga is, one is able to merge with one's own essential self. This is Prajnam Prakalpayam Uttamam Yogam Paravairagya. Paravairagya will definitely lead to the Asamprajnata Yoga. So, in the Yoga Shastra, the Uttama Yoga is, Sarvotkrushta Yoga is the Asamprajnata Yoga. And in this manner, in the कॉमेंट्री तथा च श्रवण मनन निधिध्यासनैः स्त्रीभिः हेतुर्भिः सबीज योग काले प्रज्ञां प्रकल्पयन् प्रकर्षेण विपर्यास राहित्येन उत्पादयन् तत् प्रज्ञातः परवैराग्य द्वारा वक्षमाणम् अनुत्तम योगम् निर्बीजम् लभते इति श्लोकार्थः सो व्हेन वन इज दस दिस श्लोकार्थ द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्स इज व्हेन द Sabija Yoga Kale, there is a bija, the vritti, it is a vritti, it is not asampradnyat samadhi as yet, it is still the sampradnyat, therefore the sattvic vritti is still there. So, there, by the shravan manan nididhyasana, prajnan prakalpayan, prakalpayan, prakarshena viparyasa rahityena utpadayan. So, there is no more possibility of any disturbances on account of any erroneous knowledge. As a result, tat prajnyataha paravairagya dvara. So that, with that right kind of prajnya, through the paravairagya, vakshamana anuttama yogam nirbijam labhate iti shlokartaha. So what will be told here after the nirbija yoga labhate, this is called as the uttama yoga. Before that, this samapatti and also the samadhi about that or this rutambara prajna sacha puna now this rutambara prajna what is the greatness of this rutambara prajna shruta anumana prajnyabhyam anya vishaya विशेषार्थत्वाद् दिस यू नो सूत्र इज वेरी वेरी सूक्ष्म वेरी सटल श्रुत आगम विज्ञान तत् सामान्य विषयम् व्हाट एवर वी नो अबाउट एनीथिंग थ्रू द श्रुति लिसनिंग और आगम और द वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ प्रमाण दैट इज सामान्य विषयम् इट इज द जनरल नॉलेज अबाउट एवरीथिंग नहीं आगमनेन शक्यः विशेषः अभिधातुम् द स्पेसिफिक एंड सम ग्रेट speciality of anything cannot be known through these pramanas. It cannot be known.
Kasmad why? Nahi visheshena kruto sanketaha shabda iti.
Because words cannot tell exactly specificity by practice or by kruta sankalpa, by kruta sanketa, by indicating.
So in the case of anumana, tatha anumanam samanya vishayam eva. Similarly, anumana also tells the general thing. For example, yatra praptihi tatra gati.
Where one can go from one place to another place, it is called as the movement. And if one cannot go, there is called as no movement.
So, anumanena cha samanena upasamharaha.
Therefore, anumana also tells the general knowledge about the things, not the specific knowledge.
Then, tasmat shruta anumana vishayo na visheshaha kaschidasti iti.
Therefore, by shruta anumana, there cannot be the specific knowledge about anything in this world.
Nacha asya sukshma vyavahita viprakrishtasya vastunaha loka pratyakshena grahanamasti.
And the visheshataha and the sukshmata, the subtlety of everything cannot be comprehended by any means of knowledge.
Vastunaha loka pratyakshena na grahanamasti. Nacha asya visheshasya apramanakasya abhavaha asti iti.
And also some special qualities associated with everything, they are always there.
Then samadhi prajna nigraha eva sa visheshu bhavati.
Then how the speciality about every small little thing is discovered?
It is discovered by this rutambhara prajna. And therefore bhuta sukshma gatova purusha gatova tasmad shutam anumana prajna bhyam anya visheyasa prajna visheshartatvat iti.
And therefore this prajna, which is gained through this adhyatma prasada, is such that it is able to peep beyond the known frontiers of knowledge about everything.
This is what is called a rutambhara prajna. It tells something special about it.
Like, you know, the example which I gave yesterday, that the stars and planets are moving in the cosmos. This is general knowledge. But which star is running with what speed, that is a specific knowledge. So this specific knowledge is gained through the rutambhara prajna. Similarly, in the Ayurveda, all the great rishis, when they are in the vicinity of the various herbs, etc., where from they get that this particular medicine will be useful for that particular disease. So this special knowledge, vishesha jnanam, is not in the purview of the traditional knowledge process. And this is gained by the rutambhara prajna. And therefore, this rutambhara prajna is something extremely subtle and is able to reveal that which is not revealed by any pramana. And therefore, this is shruta anumana prajna bhyam anya vishaya iti. And therefore, by this rutambhara prajna, we get that knowledge which does not belong to any means of knowledge. It is the knowledge which is intuitive knowledge. Intuitive knowledge does not fall in the purview of the Vedas or Anumana or the Pratyaksha or any pramana.
Rutambhara prajna. Now, samadhi prajna pratilambhe yoginaha prajnakrutaha samskaro navo navo jayate.
Now, from here, in this last 2-3 sutras, one very beautiful thought is developed.
This, when this rutambhara prajna happens to the yogi, then prajna krutaha samskaro namo namo jayate. Then because of this rutambhara prajna, he gets that knowledge which he never had before.
Because earlier knowledge was gathered through the study, approach, understanding, and all kinds of Shravan, Manan, Nididhyas, and everything. But now this knowledge, after the attainment of this Hrutambara Prajna, it is revealed to him. How important it is. Like, you know, there was one Mahatma. He told, you have worked on such and such project, is it not? He was looking casually, you know, BD and all that. Yes. On such and such page, there is such and such mistake. Find out. No, it cannot be. Open your book, your own thesis. So that student opened his own thesis, the same page. See, hurry, it is there. How it is there? Don't worry, it is there, no? Good. Correct it in your next edition. Now, where from this knowledge comes? This is not because of cause and effect. See? This is because of the Hrutambara Prajna. Therefore, Prajnakrita Samskaro Navo Navo Jayate. One is able to go deeper and deeper. And as a result of this, more and more powerful the chitta becomes. Tajjaha samskaraha. Anya samskara pratibandhi. Now this tajja samskaraha, that samskara which is born out of this Hrutambara Prajna. Now what is the meaning of the samskara born out of Hrutambara Prajna? Means that intuitive knowledge ability becomes so intense, as a result, anya samskara pratibandhi. The earlier samskar which were gathered in the mind through interaction, karma, karma, vipaka, karma, ashaya, samskara, vasana, all these samskaras which were gathered on the mind, they are pratibandhi, they are quietened down. Because of this Hrutambara Prajna samskar. Samadhi Prajna Prabhavaha samskaraha Vyutthana samskara ashayam badhate. See, Samadhi Prajna Prabhavaha samskaraha. So when one has practiced this Sampradnya Samadhi for a long period of time, again and again, again and again, Hrutambara Prajna is slowly, slowly developing, and as a result, because of this, Vyutthana Samskara Ashayam. So all the Samskara Ashayam, the group, the hold, the battalion of all the impressions earlier, because of which one is Vyutthana, one is going into the lower Chitta Bhumikas. Here even the Sampradnyat Samadhi becomes Vyutthana, with reference to the Asampradnyat Samadhi. Because in Asampradaya Samadhi, even the sattva is gone. There is not even a sattvic vritti. So in this Hrutambara Prajna, when it becomes more and more intense, as the result, Vitthana Samskara Ashayam Badhate. All the earlier samskaras, because of which the Vitthana, the fall takes place, are removed, are deleted, are negated. Then Vitthana Samskara Abhibhavat, tat prabhava pratyayaha na bhavanti. And therefore, vyutthana samskara abhibhavat. Because vyutthana samskara, those samskara which were gathered earlier because of the interaction with the world, when they are overpowered by this prajna samskara, Hrutambara prajna samskara, therefore, tat prabhava pratyayaha na bhavanti. Neither they are experienced nor they are able to generate the next generation of the samskar. And as a result, pratyaya nirodhe samadhi rupatishtate. So, as a result, when the vitthana samskar are no more disturbing because they are already crushed away, then samadhi hi upatishtate. Then one is able to be firmly established in this samadhi. There is no reason, there is no samskar which will pop us out of this samadhi. Because it is only the samskara or the impressions in the mind which bring us out of the samadhi. Very important. That is why we told you a number of times, when you are practicing dhyanabhyas, do not fix a particular time. Do not decide what you will do after your meditation. Do not decide that this has to be done. Because that becomes a samskara, and that samskara will throw you out of your meditation. That is why it is very, very essential. So, pratye nirodhe samadhi hi upadishtate. Then one is established in this asampradnya samadhi. Tataha samadhi ja pradnya. Tataha prajnya kruta samskaraha. Iti navo navaha samskaroshaya jayate. Now see how beautiful it is. Because of this samadhi, again the prajna becomes brighter. Because of the brightness of the prajna, again the prajna samskara become powerful. When the prajna samskara become powerful, because of that, again the prajna becomes powerful. In this manner, it is now self-propelling. One is now sucked as if towards more and more purification. Now chitta is no more holding on to the relative existence. So, tatascha prajna, tatascha samskaraha. In this manner, this prajna and samskara, purification and the effect of purification, more purification, again the effect of purification, like the karma samskar, it goes on increasing. Now a question is asked, katham asau samskaratishaya chittam sadhikaram na karishyati iti. Therefore, when you say that new samskar are created, and because of that rutambara prajna increases and so on, now the question is that these rutambara prajna samskar, will they not create again thoughts? So the reply is nate prajna kruta samskaraha kleshakshaya hetutvat chittam adhikara vashishtam kurvanti. No, this prajna samskara, prajna kruta samskaraha, they are contrary to the kleshakshaya hetu. They are contrary to the impact of the klesha, avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, abhinivesha. And because of this, they are deleting all this, and therefore they do not create any special samskar which will be leading to bondage. They will not be the klishta vrittayaha. So, adhikaram vishishtam na kurvanti, chittam hite svakarya avasadayanti, khyati paryavasanam hi chitta cheshtitam iti. So, after they have removed all the klesha samskar, as a result, what are the klesha samskar? Avidya, asmita, ragadvesha, vinivesh, they make us bhoga pravrutti. And these prajna rupa samskar, they remove this bhoga pravritti. Because there is no avidya, there is no aspita, there is no ragadvesh, there is no abhinivesh. Naturally, there cannot be the pravritti in the outer world. And therefore, they do not create any samskar. And as a result, the viveka khyati is born. Therefore, khyati paryavasanam hi. So these prajna rupa samskar, they take us up to the viveka khyati. Now what is the viveka khyati we have seen? Where purusha and the chitta are clearly and distinctly recognized. There is no doubt whatsoever. Now after this has happened, kim chasya asti? Now when this samskar which are born out of this rutambara prajna, what happens to them? They have removed this klesha samskar, is good. Then what will happen to them? Who will remove them? This is said in the last sutra of the samadhipad, tasyapi nirodhe sarva nirodhat nirbija samadhi. नाउ तस्य अपि निरोधे देन दिस प्रज्ञा संस्कार ऑल्सो बिकम्स डिलीटेड क्वाइट तस्यापि निरोधे न स केवलम समाधि प्रज्ञा विरोधी ही प्रज्ञा कृतानाम अपि संस्कारणाम प्रतिबंधी भवति कस्मात् निरोध जहां संस्कार समाधि जान संस्कारान बाधते इति सी व्हाट हैपेंस व्हाट इज द योग चित्त वृत्ति निरोधा सो ऑल द व्युत्थान संस्कार ऑल द संस्कार बॉर्न आउट ऑफ द क्लेश कर्म एटसेट्रा दे आर क्वाइटन्ड बाय दिस ऋतंभरा प्रज्ञा संस्कार नाउ व्हाट वी आर प्रैक्टिसिंग चित्त वृत्ति निरोधा योगा सो आफ्टर दे आर रिमूव्ड द क्लेश उत्पादित संस्कार व्हेन दे आर रिमूव्ड नाउ व्हाट इज लेफ्ट इज ओनली द प्रज्ञा ऋतंभरा प्रज्ञा कृत संस्कार नाउ दीज संस्कार ऑल्सो विल बी क्वाइटन्ड बिकॉज युअर अभ्यास इज व्हाट चित्त वृत्ति निरोधा And when this happens, tasyapi nirodhe sarva nirodhat nirbija samadhihi. And when that also is totally stopped, then nirodhajaha samskaraha samadhijan samskaran badhati iti. So, the nirodha samskara will subsequently quieten even this rutambhara prajna samskara also. So, nirodha sthiti kala krama anubhavena निरोध चित्त कृत संस्कार अस्तित्व अनुमेयम वित्थान निरोध समाधि प्रभव सह कैवल्य भागीय संस्कार ही चित्तम स्वस्याम प्रकृति अवस्थितायाम प्रविलीयते एंड देन दिस चित्त अलॉन्ग विद द निरोधित संस्कार दैट ऑल्सो दिस प्रज्ञा संस्कार विच आर ऑल्सो क्वाइटन विद देम द चित्त गोज बैक टू द प्रकृति प्रकृतावस्थ प्रकृति प्रकृतौ अवस्थितायां प्रविलीयते सो दोज प्रज्ञा संस्कार एंड निरोध संस्कार अलॉन्ग विद द चित्त दे डिसअपियर इन दिस अलिंग पर्यवसानम इन दिस अलिंग और दि मूला प्रकृति यस्माद् अवासिताधिकारा सह कैवल्य भागीयैहि संस्कारैहि चित्तं निवर्तते एंड इन दिस मैनर When this yasmad avasita adhikaraha saha kaivalya bhagiyaihi, so all the adhikara of this sanskara is totally gone and they also become one with the kaivalya and samskara chittam nivartate, they merge in this prakriti. So tasmin nivritte purushaha swarupa matra pratishtaha. अतः शुद्धो केवला मुक्त इति उच्यते एंड व्हेन द चित्त इज फुल्ली मर्ज इन द मूला प्रकृति अलॉन्ग विद द लास्ट ट्रेसेस ऑफ द बीज एज वेल एज दिस ऋतंभरा संस्कार एंड निरोध संस्कार व्हेन एवरीथिंग इज मर्ज इन द प्रकृति देन तस्मिन् निवृत्ते पुरुषः स्वरूप मात्र प्रतिष्ठितः देन पुरुष इज टोटली लिबरेटेड फ्रॉम The clutches of the prakriti and therefore is called as shuddha kevalaha muktaha. Kevalaha means other than the purusha, nothing else remains for the purusha to be influenced with. And this is what is called as he is liberated in this manner. In this prathama pad, samadhi pad, the teacher has given us a very exhaustive description and analysis of these 51 sutras. With this, we complete Samadhi Pad. Then we'll start the Sadhana Pad. What is that? How is that? We'll take in our next class. So now what we have to do is do the Abhyas. You have the book, read it again and again. I have gone through very exhaustively. I did not run through. So you also spend some time when I go from here. So by the time I come, this first and the second path, you must have studied very well. And during your satsang,
take up one sutra and try to speak. So that will clear your understanding and doubt. So in this evening satsang, when I go on 30th, you take up this as your evening satsang topic. With this we conclude. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.